A baby girl found dead in her mother's minivan today. She was left in a car seat for hours in near 90-degree heat.
News 5's Andrew Setters is live with tonight's top pick. Andrew?
Students and staff at Cincinnati Christian University are pulling together tonight as they deal with the tragedy here. The 11-month-old daughter of a university counseling professor found dead in the parking lot this afternoon after spending hours in her mother's minivan.
At this point, we know the child was left in the car since this morning and was found this afternoon inside a vehicle.
The 911 call came around 4:30 when Dr. Jody Edwards found her 11-month-old daughter dead inside her minivan, left behind through the heat of the day. Investigators swarmed the scene, collecting evidence, even hauling away the baby girl's car seat, then the van itself. Cincinnati Christian University President Dr. David Faust spent the afternoon talking to students and staff about what happened.
This is an unspeakable tragedy, and no words can fully express our grief and sorrow, our concern for this family.
Dr. Edwards is in her second year of teaching counseling to grad students and also performing counseling services on campus. She was working at the school ahead of the start of regular fall classes next week.
Dr. Edwards is a responsible member of our faculty, and right now our intention is to surround her and her family with support and love and prayer.
The university left the chapel open late tonight to give people a chance to grieve and talk.
Just because you believe in God, it doesn't mean you don't have terrible things happen to you, or that you sometimes don't have very difficult questions you have to wrestle with. We will deal with those from a perspective of faith and with honesty.
Now, the university will have another opportunity for staff and students to gather and grieve. They have set up a prayer service tomorrow. It's set for 9 a.m. for Dr. Edwards and her family here at the campus chapel. Live at Cincinnati Christian University, Andrew Setters, News 5.
Just horrible. In fact, this Saturday is the one-year anniversary of another tragedy involving a young child left in another hot car. Brenda Nesselrode Slaby accidentally left her 2-year-old daughter in her SUV while she worked at Glen Estee Middle School. This was last year. Prosecutors decided not to charge her. And tonight we talked to the same psychologist who counseled kids at Glen Estee after that accident. And she has a message for parents tonight. News 5's Amy Wagner has tonight's number 2 pick.
And Cherie, I spoke to some of Jody Edwards' neighbors tonight who say she's a mom who's, if anything, overprotective of her kids, the kind who slathers them with sunscreen, stays close while they play outside, and keeps them far from the street. The kind who made a horrible mistake today and is paying an unthinkable price tonight.
I honestly believe that it could happen to anyone.
And that's because Dr. Laura Stith saw it happen last year. She was called in to help students, faculty, and staff help deal with a tragedy at Glen Estee Middle School, a tragedy that rocked the entire tri-state when the assistant principal, Brenda Nesselrode Slaby, left her sleeping 2-year-old daughter, Cecilia, in the car while she was at work.
They live with just the sadness of knowing what happened and the constant running through of the what ifs. What if we had remembered, or what if she had remembered earlier, or what if somebody else had walked by the car, you know, the wanting to rewind the clock.
The same what ifs that the faculty and staff at Cincinnati Christian University are likely going through tonight. Like last year's tragic case, it was the start of the school year. The daily routine has changed, patterns are different, and Dr. Stith says stress is likely running high. It's an unfortunate formula that can often, like today, lead to tragedy.
This is a child that we're talking about, so I know that there are people thinking, but it's a child. But it's still, it's a change in a routine, and when we're overwhelmed and stressed, we can forget.
And I spoke with Brenda Nesselrode Slaby tonight. She was very shaken up to hear this happened again. She plans to contact the Edwards family and says she's not ready yet to speak publicly about what happened to her. I'm Amy Wagner, News 5.